All right. Hello, everybody, and welcome to another one of our conversations here with Dan. I just want to kind of start up front. I know I mentioned this a couple of weeks ago if you read the intros to a couple of the videos, but we've kind of been out of pocket for the last couple of weeks, and so we were doing some more of these short form, more of our personal preference type questions, but always with a spiritual focus, which is hopefully a good example of some other ways we could have conversations with people. You know,
right.
You know, talking about Bible things doesn't always have to mean that we need to exegete a passage necessarily.
Right.
But we're going to have one more of these sort of personal preference conversations. And next week, we're going to dive back into all the questions that have been coming in. And we would really encourage you, if you've been holding on to a question, or maybe these discussions just of our personal preferences have sparked a question, make sure to send it on in. That way we can continue to have these various discussions for this week. Dan, what is one of your favorite songs to sing in worship? New, old, whatever.
Oh, in worship, you say? Okay.
I'm not asking what's your favorite, like, Eagles song or something, but...
Yeah, I like that guitar solo in Hotel California. Never mind. Go ahead.
That's a discussion in my podcast.
Yeah,
no. But yeah, what's one of your favorite songs in worship?
Well, I have a lot of them, both old and new. If you go back to old songs, Bernard of Clairvaux's O Sacred Head, because the words of that song so graphically describe gratitude and indebtedness to God for his great love and mercy.
Yeah.
You know, what language can I borrow to thank thee, dearest friend, for this thy dying sorrow, thy pity without end? Mm-hmm. Oh, make me thine forever. And should I fainting be, oh, let me never, never outlive my love to thee. That's powerful.
It is.
Years ago, I read Bernard of Clairvaux's sermon on the love of God, which was similar to that song. And,
and
I've been in love with that song ever since. So that's an oldie that is one of my favorites.
Yeah. I really struggle with this question because... It is like I want to categorize.
Oh, yeah, there's so many of them.
Yeah, I want to say this is my favorite teaching song. This is my favorite personal connection song and different things. I honestly, and this may surprise people that have had this conversation with me before, but my favorite hymn is Be Still and Know. Like, there's other ones that I have emotional connection to from camps or colleges. And
Be Still and Know That You Are God?
Be Still and Know That I Am God. Just if I just had that one little piece of melody and that one line, but then it has other thoughts to it, but that one alone is enough for me because I like to work. I like to stay on the move. I like to be busy doing something. If I'm sitting down, even if there's nothing else going on, I want to have a game in front of me while I'm watching the TV and the kids are talking to me. Like, I'm that person. I need stuff going on.
Yeah.
And so that song is the one that, you know, it's a verse, it uses other spiritual teaching, you know, I'm the way, the truth, and the light, all the, but that beginning kind of sets up a thought process for me.
You know, that's almost like one of the ancient chants, because they were so simple, and yet so profound. Do you remember a song that we, I don't know if we've ever sung it here with you, but... Come into our hearts with your peace.
Yeah.
You alone, O Lord, are holy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very chant-like.
You know, very chant-like, but it's a very thought-provoking, simple song. So we've talked about some of the simpler ones. What else you want to ask about songs?
But if you were to pick one of maybe the, since we both had older songs that we kind of gravitate towards. It's funny because a lot of the older songs, I spend a lot of time breaking down the intent of the song and the teaching of the song, and I do appreciate that a lot of newer stuff has some really deep teaching or storytelling.
Yeah, some of them are great biblical songs, and some of them aren't worth the paper they're written on. But
same with old ones.
Old ones, too.
I mean, that's the fun thing. I have tons of old songbooks, and the number of songs that don't make it out of one songbook, let alone... two or three into the days, I still love In Christ Alone. Like, as much as we sing it, as much as it's played, it it tells the story so succinctly.
It is a Christ hymn, and yes, it is very similar to the kind of thing that ancient Christians sang.
Mm-hmm.
It's simple, but it captures our relationship with Christ, and that only Christ can give us hope. I think that's a fantastic song.
Yeah, it's one that I think will probably last a good long while.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there's other fun songs I like to sing that are newer, and you know, even if they're direct out of scripture.
Yeah.
But that's one that I think will have some staying power.
Well, one of them that is an old song that's been made new is Just As I Am, I Come Broken.
Oh, yeah.
And, of course, Just As I Am has been around forever, and it's a great song in and of itself.
Mm-hmm.
But I Come Broken, I Come Wounded, you know, that the chorus that they've put on there is fantastic for that song because it captures penitence in the heart of a person and our dependence on the grace of God. And it captures some of the same ideas you find in a great song like Amazing Grace.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And so that's one of mine. And I also like At the Cross, Love Ran Red. Is that what it is?
Yes.
Yeah. That's an awesome song because it describes the atonement, those central ideas of the gospel. And, you know, it's so close to you know, passages like John 12:32, how God draws us to Him through His love. It's a great song.
Yeah, and I'll mention one more. Like I say, I have a list, but like, if I go past those two, the one that when it comes on my playlist, I turn it up every time, and just like it's the belt sing sort of get excited song, is one called Highest Hope. We haven't introduced it here yet. It's actually one that I have on a list of possibility. But it goes, "You're my highest hope, your glory I long to see. All who are thirsty come, the fountain is flowing and free. You are my rest, you are my peace. You are the hope to all who believe. Faithful and true, you always will be my highest hope."
That sounds very good.
It's a great little chorus.
Mm-hmm.
And it's one of the verses starts off like, "Just when I can't seem to find a reason to trust that there's more." And then it keeps going on from there. So it's a very like personal introspection, and then it's a declaration song.
Good.
So it's not one that I connect to as deeply on a consistent basis, but it's like a good jam. You know, every time it comes on, I crank that thing and I sing along.
One of my favorites that I think is deeply sound theologically and very powerful emotionally to me is the song, "How Great Is Our God."
Oh, yeah.
You know, "The splendor of the King clothed in majesty."
Yeah.
"Let all the earth rejoice."
Mm-hmm.
And that song about God and the majesty of God and our praising of God it's both biblical and it's extremely, well, even like the praises in Revelation, it's so good. And what's that one, Agnus Dei?
Oh, yeah.
That's awesome.
The Alleluia.
Yes.
Yeah, that one. Yeah, that one's a really pretty
worthy
one.
"Worthy is the Lamb" comes right out of Revelation.
Right.
That's a wonderful.
That's something, there's a lot of songs we sing that come straight out of Revelation. Because we seem to gravitate towards the holy, holy, and the Alleluia, and those sort of things. So, what are y'all's favorite songs?
And why? What is it that is so biblically profound in those songs or personally touching in those songs that helps you spiritually when you sing those songs?
Yeah, because there's a ton of them out there.
Mm-hmm.
I think last year at the Broadway Church of Christ, we sang 430-something songs, different ones. So, and that's leaving out probably another 50 that we've sung in years past.
Mm-hmm.
And again, that's not touching them all. So there's a lot of possibilities, and we would encourage you to think deeply about why that song is important to you.
Oh, one more thing. I think that biblically, our song repertoire has a hole in it, and the hole is the lament.
Oh.
We have almost no laments.
Well, like
now,
our,
we sing one, "From the depths of our soul, from the depths of my soul, I cry out."
Deep calls to deep.
Deep calls to deep, but there's almost no other laments that we sing, and there are many people that are struggling in life, and the lament is a great vehicle to put them in touch with God at times of sorrow.
I I've got a couple of them on standby.
Well, teach them to us.
I hope so. Yeah.
Judd's a great, he's weird as all get out, but he's a great worship leader.
Maybe that's a part B to this.
And his mind does not work like mine, but he's a great worship leader.
But a good part B might be if you've got good lament songs that you use in your church, let us know those too.
That
They're
would be
good
really
to know.
Good.
All right. So thanks again for coming with us over these last couple weeks. Like I said, we should return to our, you know, regularly scheduled broadcast next week. But thanks again for your subscription, for your comments. We'll see you again next week.